2012. But he said you presented a paper sometime back at Chennai. I would like to see what the progress you have made, and some of my students at that time were not happy the way you presented it. I said, then I have to definitely come. There is no option. And he was of the opinion whether the students have really understood the concept, how easy, how difficult to even talk about a CKD. And I thought, let me put forward, I should, at the first instance itself, convey my apologies to him for not bringing all the cases. I'll be just discussing about 30 cases. I must be definitely having another 30 cases report. If somebody finds time, come to me. You can sit with my other colleague and dig out the data, put it in a form, because it is habitual for me now to treat them than documenting it. But the documents are available. What I mean to say, another 30 definitely I can give you. Anybody is interested can look into it. I'll give the records. But I'll be comparing 15 cases of my middle years of practice and 15 cases of my later years of practice, and I will openly confess my blunders as an early and amateur and immature Ayurvedic physician when I graduated. Okay, why I'm saying this? These days we are all living under the sentiment of text of Ayurveda. Seldom we are prepared to stand for the acid test. We all live in our comfort zone. Whenever somebody questions, we say Ayurveda, Dashaveda Pariksha, though we not apply even one. A obese person coming to my clinic, I'm not sure whether it's Prakriti or Vikriti. Okay? I should admit it's my ignorance than the lack of science behind it. At least I put it that way. Are we prepared to do that kind of introspection? And I'm not going to preach Ayurveda today, since I was told there are a lot of students coming from different parts of the country. I thought, let me openly confess how this journey started. There are several conditions like this. Maybe this is one of the occasions where I'll be speaking about these experiences. And sometime we are also now working on thyroid disorders. We are now talking about the iodine salt induced hypothyroidism in India, carefully mapping it. Now group of doctors joined me and they are agreeing. Since 1999 and 2009, in 10 years, there is 20-fold increase in hypothyroidism because we are using iodine salt and nobody reports it. Just we are carried away. Iodine is treatment for hypothyroidism. Without understanding, iodine induces hypothyroidism. We are not even ready to debate with modern fraternity with proof, if we have proof. Because 1999, government made it mandatory to use only iodized salt. So before that 10 years and after that 10 years, there is 20-fold increase, and we don't look into the text, what biochemistry says when it comes to hypothyroidism and iodine. So a lot of things. So my point here will be just, I will quickly take you through some of the fundamentals. Since students are there, it's my responsibility to take you through the fundamentals. And then probably in two parts, I will share my experiences, giving you what should be the approach. Now, what is this, the often spoken chronic kidney disease? CKD. In the earlier years, this is the same thing which we used to discuss as CRF, a chronic renal failure. And why do we discuss this more? If you look at CKD definition, it is any damage or a decreased level of function which is determined through GFR rate, which is divided into about 5 stages. And this is the international criteria which is followed when it comes to the diagnosis. This is how we get the conditioned reflex. No? We are all animals. Once we understand, a reflex can be exhibited. This is the best example. So any damage, if it is there for about 3 months, defined by structure, maybe your CT, ultrasonogram, scintigraph today. But most importantly, when it comes to the diagnosis part, you will be depending upon glomerular filtration rate, which can be diagnosed on the basis of your creatinine. That's what today we say EGFR, the estimated glomerular filtration rate. Anything below 60% is where we start considering these conditions as the CKD. The question is, why are we discussing about it? Is it really having any significance? Definitely. If you look at the entire world, these are available, I will just show it, you can read it. This is how it stands in UK and US, and this is how it stands in India. Any disease having about 8.8%, which is equal to almost 1%, is really going to trouble us. And this is when we are able to diagnose. I have seen a boy of about 4 years who came to me is grade 1. Okay? At that age, we have to pray God and have to wait for the response, because he is neither diagnosed with hypertension nor with diabetes, not your autoimmune kidney disease, nothing else, glomerular nephritis. It is diagnosed. So, love it or leave it, that's the policy. The boy is now free from any of the symptoms, and his ultrasonogram today shows there is absolutely no parenchymal damage. You may believe or may not believe, but I followed Ayurveda. Related to Ashwini, they said in the younger age group, below adolescence age group, sadhya, yunikruchaha. Maybe that is applicable to these conditions also. The criteria which we have to adopt should have a base. And his father is joining me next week for my Kailash Yatra. Okay? And the boy is without any symptoms, and his creatinine levels are normal now. There is another parameter what I can suggest. Because grade 1, you don't get any symptoms. Not at all. And God has only to give you some signal through which you go for a routine examination, you will come to know. Otherwise, up to sometimes grade 3 also symptomless. So when they are symptomless, why are we labeling this as Vrukkasodha XYZ? The symptoms are not available. And we always debate why should we use the modern tools of diagnosis. One side, we are reluctant to use the modern tools, saying that Ayurveda doesn't require. The other side, we give Vrukkasodha, Vrukkajanisodha. I'll tell you, a lot of published literature by great scholars. Several titles have been given for chronic renal failures. Several treatments have been attempted. Rogamadav Parikshetha Tatonantaramo. That is the protocol. You diagnose as per Ayurveda lines, no problem. You use the modern tools, diagnose, apply Ayurvedic tools, that is also okay. Are we there somewhere in between or not is the question. There are a lot of organizations across the globe which are working. I am leaving this presentation for you. Okay. Now, what are the causes of this kidney disease? Before going to the causes of chronic renal failure or chronic kidney disease, I would like to first of all mention to you that I am not going to talk to you about the acute renal failure. It is a total different story which will be concluded in about sometimes days or weeks time, sometimes less than 1 year. The fate will be decided. It also has all the 5 stages. So terminal stage, anyway, you will come across in both the cases, but I am not going to talk to you about this. The general causes, as you are aware, is diabetes and hypertension, and then your glomerular nephritis and congenital conditions. Okay, this is how the etiology stands today. The top being diabetes, okay, and next being your hypertension, and not to forget, we are getting a lot of interstitial, chronic interstitial diseases and autoimmune conditions also. This is how the Indian scenario stands, matching with the global scenario, okay? And this interstitial nephritis, which is leading to renal failures, and this is glomerular nephritis resulting in renal failures, and These are autoimmune kidney diseases. These days we are getting autoimmune conditions. Maybe it may not be the right platform, but sometime in 2006 I presented a paper at Delhi in one of the international workshops saying that autoimmunity is ojovriddhi. I don't know whether we can understand this or not, but if you have time I'll send across the paper to you. Carefully think over. In Mahabharata we have two great characters who fought for about 20 days with each other. One is Bakasura, and then the other one is Bhima. Both were having the equal strength when it was in the Ekachatrapura. Instead of sending that boy from his landlord, Bhima went and tried to sacrifice himself. He fought with this giant for about 18 days, ultimately conquered. That means the giant was also having the same strength like Bhima, but Bhima was using his strength for good and good cause, and the other one is not. That's how I can simply define. But if you look at Visramta and Vyapat as the, and Kshaya as three states of Ojas, Visramta and Vyapat requires Vriddhi. Please read the commentary of Hemadri on Ojas. You will come to know. He was questioning. In fact, he is the only person in the history of Ayurveda who questioned this and said, without Vriddhi, Visramta and Vyapat are not possible. Kshaya, marana mitya kshaya. So your deficiency leads to death. Immunocompromisation is a state which you can call Visramta, and Vyapati is the autoimmunity. The three states of your immune system have been mentioned. Are we going to the fundamental level and look at what is happening in each condition? Maybe the concept works here, that's what I want to say, if we apply it clinically. I would like to quickly take you through the five stages. These are the five stages. I am going to talk to you about mostly this spectrum. These days 3B is also there, because where your GFR is about 45 and less. So these are the cases where, according to me, we should not make any attempt to go for specific treatment, because these are the asadhya states. When a disease is in the vyakti state, it is asadhya. When a disease is at the bedha state, it is the pratyakshaya. Shushruta clearly mentioned it. So when all the symptoms are surfacing, it is asadhya. Sarva sampurna lakshana asadhya. Very simple. So take your fundamentals. When you have studied about Shatkriya Kalas, apply it in clinical practice. We always think that is of no use. You can apply the same Shatkriya Kalas in the metastasis, invasion, when it comes to cancer. You can apply everywhere. These are the fundamental concepts given to you. It's the best tool given to you. Whether you are using it or not is a different story. Okay? As I was mentioning, see here, once it comes down to somewhere between 60 and 80, we will focus on this, and following all the cases up to 45 and less than 15 is where we consider as end-stage renal disease. These are the Kidney Foundation of Canada defines all the five stages. Again, in US also they follow the same trend. In UK, a study reveals the spectrum, and finally these are the five stages of this thing. If you look at it, always the first stage is about 90-80%. It should be 80% when you should start considering it is stage 1. Then between 60 and 80 we'll be taking it to stage 2. And up to 60 we will be taking it as, between 30 and 60 we will be taking it as stage 3. Why I am giving this? I will show you some of the cases. It's not that I have not taken. I have taken terminally ill patients who are on dialysis. I was foolish to start with, because we get our consultation, usually we don't want to forego that. I was also doing the same thing, nothing to hide. But as the time progressed, in my total career, each case was a research for me than a practice. Therefore, I could track what is happening to them. And mostly I was taking the cue from what they have mentioned and what my teachers were pronouncing, and I tried to apply, and in the process I learnt a lot of things. Okay, this is what is which is going to worry us. You cannot even define how much time it takes most of the times. When I reviewed the literature, even it has taken 40 years for a patient to start a stage 1 and reach stage 5. And it has not given even 40 months time in some of the patients. So it all depends upon the other factors like hypertension, diabetes, multiple factors. If they are involved, the prognosis will be poor, and progression of the condition is very fast. The progression is what is going to define the stage, and this is a terminal stage which is ultimately going to kill the patient. So what are the symptoms of CKD? Again, as I started mentioning to you, I am not going to discuss about acute renal failure. I am aware your pre-renal, post-renal and intra-renal causes of renal failure, acute. Let us ignore this. Let us proceed. This is very simple. Okay. If you come to the symptoms, at around the second, third stage, 3A, 3B, you see edema, pedal edema, but continuously one thing which you can document is GFR, increase, decrease, and headaches which we usually ignore. Fatigueness is something which usually we ignore, the fatigueness. Why I'm saying this? In Kshatriya Kalas, loss of appetite is there in Kapha. And Ashmari, again, I'm taking an example because it's in the spectrum of Mutra Kruchna to your Prameha. If you carefully go through this, starts with Kapha. This disease starts with Kapha. Prameha is Kapha. So Agnimandya is mentioned, that means increased creatinine is resulting in the loss of appetite, which we are ignoring. We thought Ayurveda was quoting Agnimandya and several conditions, so why to focus on Agnimandya here? The very Agnimandya here is indicating the increased creatinine levels. So this is where I want to tell you how to use the modern tools for presenting your own observations to the scientific world. Okay, time and again I'll be saying this because we are living under sentiments. We wear pant and shirt, we use AC rooms, we use all modern, we have urbanized ourselves, but we are leaving Ayurveda in the jungle. We don't want to bring Ayurveda along with us. We want to keep Ayurveda in the forest. We want to live in the urban area. Bring it along with you. Contemporize it. Use it for its best way. I was speaking to an audience at a Medanta hospital last month, where they have 6 Ayurveda doctors who are really working and developing protocols of integration. Integration is not prescribing an allopathic drug and Ayurvedic drug on the same prescription. Integration is using it, their medicine in your gray areas and using your medicines in their gray areas. That's how it should happen, and this is one of the cases. That's why I'll be emphasizing this way in between. Okay, now it takes several years to develop the symptoms, otherwise they're all symptomless. These are the 12 symptoms which you should always remember in your mind. Changes in the urinary function. This may be frequency increased or decreased, which you see in the spectrum what I was mentioning, but Mutra Kruchna to Prameha. All are linked. If you carefully open that Mutra Kruchna chapter and see all the 20 Pramehas, like it was discussed, I was about to say, in Shukrameha, we started doing Semenorrhea. Instead of writing it as Semenorrhea, directly mentioned by somebody, it is retrograde ejaculation, okay? And simple treatment. I have 6 cases only documented so far. Aupatkar Churan. For me, Thambrul is Aupatkar Churan. If it is diabetes, among the Prameha, only one condition, Madhumeha, I remove the Sita Churan and make my Aupatika Churan, which will be literally bitter, really bitter, but it takes care of even diabetes. I have case reports. Otherwise, the main emphatic indication in the Phalashruti of Aupatikara Churana, Jayanti Vinshatin Mehan. How many of you think that Ayurveda can do justice to this condition? Now you have seen the seriousness. I have threatened you rather, okay, by saying don't touch this, so many things. Now half of you might have lost your interest even in taking up this case if it comes to your clinic tomorrow. By default they come to us because they are not left with an option. They have tried everything available in the world and then think, okay, let us try this system. That's where how things happen. Let us live with it. It is the truth. Now from this, what we are going to derive? Do we have any activity to contribute to? I definitely say yes, if you understand your own science. Now these are the crucial 7 points which I will highlight. These are the highlights of my observation. Now stage 1 to stage 2 CKDs, mostly they are symptom free. Then how to diagnose an Ayurvedic lens is the first question. Then stage 3, most of the symptoms are related to the urine turbidity. You don't find sodha as a symptom or upadrava or arista or purarupa in Prameha. So 30% of the cases with diabetes are coming to you. So how can you say that? Then say it as Vyadhi Sankara. What is bad about it? Say it as Nidanardhakar Roga. All the Nidanardhakar Rogas have not been defined in Ayurveda. Vikara Nama Kushilo Na Jihriyat Kadachana Nahi Sarva Vikaranam Namatosti Dhruvastiti. I have given a clear statement. It is Charaka. He had given a statement very clear. He is going to depend upon symptoms. And many people debate with me. Oh, doc, you have not followed any Chikitsa Sutra. Ayurvedic fundamentals. I say Charaka had not followed. In 4th chapter of Sutrasthana, he bypassed all his dosha, dusha, everything. He said symptom. Dasemane Kasagnani, Dasemane Swasaharani, Dasemane Daha Prasamanani, Dasemane Solagnani. If any credit goes, it goes to Charaka. Blame goes to Charaka. I am only tool. I am Nimitta Karana. Vaidya is a Nimitta Karana. Okay, so I am a tool. I am using Ayurveda and I am doing my part. Stage 4 and 5, diabetes and so on and so forth. So here you have to take up the Shatriya Kalas and apply the symptoms mentioned there properly to understand whether it is Nidanardhakar Roga or Vyadhi Sankara. My understanding at the end of about 10 years after doing several mistakes, I concluded, and today I will be writing it as Prameha, whether with other diseases associated with or not, it is Prameha for me. Because people who come to me, if you ask the questions, they say frequency of urination is increased, there is turbid urine, if their symptoms are expressive. Fortunately, as I mentioned, most of them are second and third, one or other symptoms will be there in their case. So the drug which I have picked up will be interesting for you. I will give you the reasons why I picked up also. I picked up Bhumi Amalaki, and Chennai has given me that insight into this disease. In 1999, when I came to Chennai and joined my CGHS, I received a case from my previous colleague from Hyderabad, Dr. Venkataya. He is a film financier, no more. He passed away in 2006, if I am right. He came to me in 99. He was found HIV positive and he had some Siddha drugs. He developed, in fact, his acute renal failure, I cannot say it's a chronic renal failure, and he approached us. And you have to give some treatment. I'm scared, I cannot give Punarnava Mandur, which was my regular prescription. When I started thinking, I require two things. One is an antiviral herb, definitely not anything else. And another one which works on Prameha because the symptoms are all matching with Prameha. I shortlisted Tulasi and Bhumi Amalaki, which are antiviral. But Tulsi is not that significantly prescribed in Prameha. Bhumi Amalaki in Bhava Prakash Nigantu and Raja Nigantu is prescribed in Prameha. And my teacher, Dr. V.V. Ram Shastri, he did his study on Bhumi Amalaki in Madhumeha. So these were improved, okay.